I just came across something in the book I'm working on right now that I thought I would talk about for a minute, and it's how we as audiobook narrators use proximity to the mic to sort of change tone and hopefully make what's printed on the page make more sense. So, what I'm dealing with right now is thoughts in a character's head. So those thoughts are in italics. What I'll do a lot is I'll move in really close to the mic if it feels appropriate and speak in a quieter way for the italicized bits. Being really close to the mic changes the way the audio sounds pretty significantly. You can tell the distance. You can hear more of the room if I move away from the mic, and you can hear only my voice as I get closer and closer to the mic. Of course, you can't hear that here because this is all recorded on the microphone on my phone. But so I'm just going to read the paragraph with the thought bits in there, and you'll see me moving closer and changing my voice and then moving away. And hopefully that helps the listener as they're listening to the book to really understand what's happening and make it a little more immersive. Also, these lines have some cursing in them. So if you're like in the car, you wouldn't be in the car because this is a video. Hopefully you're not watching this in the car, but just be aware I'm about to curse. Okay, it sounds like this. The vault of the bridge loomed over him, dread-soaked. No light from Duke Street reached him, and it was so dark within the vault, the void appeared solid. He was in a cold sweat, and his heart beat wildly, arrhythmically. What the fuck am I doing? He thought. Paying your tax, a sterner voice answered. So there you go. It's simple, but just how close or how far you are from the mic can make a really big difference. And I think it helps make the audiobook a little better.